Before I get started on anything else, I want to talk about the AM5 silencer or even the Ops Model 12 silencer. I believe it would also count for the AM22 as well as the AM30. They're set up similar. It's a reflex can and it's set up for a known distance, like this distance from here to here. You have to have a barrel that accepts these collars at the correct distance, and then you can thread on the silencer. So I have set up this M4 profile barrel to run a collar and align it for the AEM5. Now, that matters because Allen Engineering, as well as the old Ops Inc., make different kinds of cans. So I'm going to use Allen Engineering as an example because you can buy them right now and find pictures and specs on them. So the AEM 2 and 3 and 4, what's different between an AEM 4 and this? Because they're almost the same size, maybe just a little bit shorter. Well, the internal dimension is different. Now, I don't know this from Mr. Allen, but just on what I've learned from doing this, he set up the AEM 2, 3, and 4, or the corresponding Ops models, to work on a barrel with a grenade launcher cut. So I have taken this M4 profile collar here, which should go on an M4 barrel, and it wouldn't fit. It would just bottom out, and this AEM5 can wouldn't even hit the threads. It would be like this, clunk, and like the threads for the can are actually up here. So I had to walk this thing back so that the threads would engage and engage 10, actually 11 turns. Now, that's important because it covers up the M4 cut. I could no longer mount an M203 grenade launcher because it kind of floats over this M203 cut here. A little bit, just a little bit. So they invented the cans with a different internal dimension, the AM4, 3, and 2, to function on rifles that have an M4 cut so you can still mount an M4 grenade launcher. Now, it's not a big deal for people who don't own one, but it's a big deal for the military who want to set up their M4 rifle and still mount a grenade launcher on it. So that's why there's two different models, and that's why there's different kinds of collars. Now, that's important because this muzzle brake and this collar are set up for the Spikes LRS, a long reflex silencer. And I assume, based on what I've learned doing this, that the Spikes silencer is set up for the AEM4 or AEM2 spec of barrel. You know, the default collar on this M4 started here where the cold blue was, and he had to walk it back to right about there, so maybe over half an inch, maybe 5/8, in order to make this longer profile work. When you have a custom Douglas barrel on a Mark 12, you can make the profile whatever you want. But when you have to work within the bounds of an M4, that's the difference. So the Spike stuff is set up to work default, I'm assuming, based on these two parts that I purchased, with the M4 profile barrels and not the Mark 12 profile barrels. So if you bought a Spikes long reflex, it might actually work, but it's going to screw way further down depending on which collar that you use, or it might not even hit at all. So having talked about those different types of silencers, let's actually get into what I have learned with this. I had to walk this collar back. By default, this Spikes collar was too short, so the threads wouldn't even engage. It would just hit this taper, and then it would bottom out, and the threads wouldn't contact. So if you notice here, it actually kind of floats over the M24-09 cutout, or M203 cutout, sorry, the grenade launcher cutout. Now, since we're looking at these right now, there's a couple dimensions here that are important. One being, I'm going to assume, whether we pick the beginning or the end of the threads, there's a mark right here on the collar from where the collar has, the silencer has worn off the finish. So if we look at that and we transfer it over here, you'll notice that the threads on this extend way further into the can than they do on the actual Allen Engineering brake. And that becomes important because this Ballistic Advantage barrel with this setup and also with this collar was on here. You can see the marks. This silencer only tightened on 7.5 times, 7.5 fold rotations, which is the bare minimum. Ron Allen recommends 7 to 10 turns for it to tighten on. Which means, in turn, that the internal threads of the can, see the bright ring there that are the internal threads? It means that they didn't get completely threaded on, and there were four or five threads exposed to the gases of the silencer. Now, we'll come back to that later. When I went to this one, and I went to tighten it on, I couldn't tighten it on all the way, because this guy tightens on 11 turns. Since the gunsmith turned this barrel, he just kind of ran it out, and when we put the collar on, it tightened on 10 times. I stacked it out with some of these shims to line it up with the pin and weld hole that was already in the barrel, and that's how I came to 11 and a half turns. So, the carbon that was built up inside the threads that were left not screwed on caused it to be difficult to turn on. I actually had to clean this out with brake fluid on the inside to break up that carbon well enough to get it to thread all the way down, because it would just thread down and stop. I originally thought that this was actually hitting the first baffle. It was not. It was carbon in the threads. Let's talk about that. Baffle distance. We look at the distance from here to here. This is a Allen Engineering brake and collar. It's just over 4 inches. His specs for this are on his website. You know, it's kind of rough. 4.1 inches. 4.8 whatever. So if we line it up with the mark on the collar, you'll notice that this muzzle brake is significantly longer. And you're like, well, is it going to hit the first baffle? No, it doesn't hit the first baffle. What I've learned taking measurements with rods is that I have about an eighth of an inch. So it sits this close to the first baffle. So it's very close. It does fit. So you have approximately, let's leave that measurement right there. Let's do this. It's just about an eighth of an inch. So let's call it that. And then let's bring it over here. So you have roughly that much space with a factory setup with 7 turns. Now you're going to lose a little bit. If you do 10 turns, you're going to lose a couple shims worth. But the downside of that is it takes up all the blast chamber. Now it works fine. And if you look inside this can, put a mag through it just to test it. Let's see if I can get that lit up here. Look at the mark it made on my first blast baffle there. That is the gas escaping from the end of this muzzle device. Spike's tactical muzzle device. It just kind of shoots out there and makes those marks on the blast baffle because it's firing basically right into it. See? So that Spike's tactical brake kind of makes its mark on the blast baffle. Now, am I worried about it? No, I'm not worried about it. It's zeroed. It doesn't baffle strike. Will it erode in the shape of that? Yes, if I put 20,000 rounds through it, you'll see some erosion. I'm not too worried about it. Most people don't shoot their silencers enough for it to be a problem. But the big difference is the Allen Engineering is just flat. There's no gases coming out of the end like a hot jet. So I think that that's an interesting lessons learned that, you know, you might not see. Now, if this brake was the same length, would it make the same impacts? Yes, they'd just be wider. They wouldn't be so focused. But that's something that you have to take into account. If I were to run the M4 collar on this, like, I couldn't use this because I actually couldn't step it back far enough the way this was set up. I would actually have to turn that collar back so that it sits like this and it would fall into the M209 cut. You know, it would just be weird. So it would basically look like that, and I decided that I didn't want to necessarily do that to make it work with this setup, so I used the reflex collar so he didn't have to machine back that much. But that's just a brief rundown of some of my lessons learned running this can and actually using a mishmash of parts that kind of Allen Engineering never intended to be used. You know, he wants you to use the proper M4 can with the M4 collar and the M4 barrel. You know, if I had an AEM4, I would not have had to have modified this barrel to make this work. Mr. Allen also does not recommend using Spike's tactical parts, but since I had everything together in one unit, I was able to get it set up like that at the machinist's. I was worried about this brake not being long enough to pin and weld to 16 inches. I think that it would have worked, actually. So having done it, having the chance to do it again, I probably would not use this brake. I would probably pin and weld this brake. But I did what I did. It functions fine. This is just some information to use when you're shopping. Honestly, I think the AM5 can is good. It was very gassy on this gun. I don't have a silencer charging handle. I don't know how big of a difference that'll make. I was this close to actually just buying an AEM4 because the AEM4 collars for the Mark 12 barrel are easy to find. But my friends talked me out of it, and I was able to actually trade into this silencer with some extra gun parts. So I ended up with the AEM5. I now have two rifle setups that I can run it on, and I need to get a different grub screw. Don't worry. I just need to find one with the right threads, you know. But it since it floats over the M203 cut, I actually have to get one that's longer because the store I went to didn't have. I thought it was an M6, but it's an M6 fine thread, not an M6 coarse thread. So at any rate, this is kind of a basic rundown of the lessons that I've learned from setting up a second rifle to use the Mark 12 silencer.